What's up, guys, and welcome to another Clone Wars Season 5 episode review. So today I'm going to be reviewing the 14th episode, which is called Eminence, and it was the, well, if you see it as it airs, then it was the first episode of the Maul arc, because the revival got pushed way in front as the first episode of the season, but actually it is sort of the second part of the Maul story arc in Season 5. So it was really a great way to start. Well, to continue the arc, basically, and start the whole Death Watch Alliance thing with Maul. It was really cool to see that, and I think, yeah, they did it really well. And it was, even though it was just, like, in the past, for the past arcs, I always said, it was a fine introduction for this arc, but it was not too good. Well, that definitely was different here. It was a great introduction, but it was also with action-packed, and it was exciting, and it was interesting and cool. It was just way different than another way than, like, all the other episodes to start an arc. So, really as epic as I expected. Then, everyone who, it's like, it's just interesting to see that everyone who meets Maul and Savage now says, like, you're no Jedi, what are you, who are you, or something like that. I don't know. I mean, can't they see, like, can't they activate, like, it, like, sorry for saying like that often, but Pre Vizsla, when he, well, the Death Watch, actually, the Death Watch salvage team, sort of, that goes into the ship, the escape pod, where Maul and Savage are, he finds the lightsaber. Why doesn't he pick it up and just see, and just activate it and see if he's Sith or Jedi or whatever? It's like, because they always be like, who are you? And that, I don't know, it is understandable, it gets kind of annoying soon. Then I find these ships, these infiltrator ships, I think they're sort of called, the Mandalorians have, the Death Watch. I think they're awesome. Yeah, really cool. Just wanted to point that out. And I also want to point out that Savage is like really, you see really, he's like without a plan, aggressive. He's just very brutal. You see, like, when he wakes up, first thing he does is beat up these three med droids, or whatever you call them, that were actually repairing him and giving him his robot arm. And also, yeah, it's cool that he now has a robot arm, and Maul has his new legs. That's great. That's way better than the old thing. Yeah, the old sort of not really great solution by Mother Talzin. But yeah, it's great that they now have their new body parts. And, yeah. It's interesting that to see that Pre Vizsla isn't really, well, no, let me just say like this, that Pre Vizsla doesn't threaten Maul when he force chokes Bo-Katan, like, put her down, or, well, not really threatens, but says something, that he should put her down or something like that, because, and he even says, like, hold your fire. Well, okay, fire, yes, but, like, hold your gun sort of thing, when the Mandos step up for Bo-Katan and are ready to shoot Maul. Sorry. Yeah, I don't know, it's, well, I guess, whatever. Okay, then it's cool to see the Hutt Council and also Black Sun. I only know the Black Sun, actually, from the game Star Wars The Old Republic. It is also a crime syndicate there, and yeah, it's just cool to see also the Hutt Council. Well, it's not really the full Hutt Council, but it's sort of like a similar thing as what happened in Season 3, Episode 9, what was it, Hunt for Zero, where Zero talks to the Hutt Council. And, like, Poe is awesome. Bo-Katan is just awesome with her, also with her new hair. Yeah, it is new, right? In Season 4, she had different hair, but yeah, a great new character style of her, and she shows her face way more often, yes, and it's just awesome how she says, well, negotiations have gone as planned, and, I think Bo-Katan is a really awesome character, and I would definitely like to see more of her, and they definitely fulfilled my wish in this episode. And it's also cool to see that Lazarazi and all the other, yeah, also Dengar, even though Dengar or Lazarazi, I think the most didn't even have any lines, but it was cool to see them return, and yeah, that was just awesome. And, yeah, it was just interesting. Sorry if I say interesting all the time. It was cool to see how Maul like talks to Vizsla, like even though like Death Watch found him and gave him new legs and sort of brought him back on his normal journey, how he still says, like, I know, he just looks into the future, but how he says the whole time, my plan and my vision, and without me, you wouldn't really have anything or any big plan, so we're gonna go do this my way. That's just interesting to see, and yeah, I did post a spoiler video. I don't know, it was like a month, maybe 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago. Go check that out if you want to. If you don't want to be spoiled, then don't check it out. And it also says what happens. Well, you can sort of already know it when, at the end of the episode now, Pre Vizsla says, we will have the two brothers also locked up or something. I won't say anything now, I don't want to spoil you, sorry. And yeah, so this episode was really great, it was a great introduction. I think it deserves a 9.5 out of 10. Sorry if I'm picky, I think it should be a 10 out of 10. I'm just giving it a 9.5 out of 10. Yeah, I don't know why. Yeah, because for the arc, like, the main thing is the whole Darth Sidious thing. I'm really hyped for that, and I don't know, I'm sorry. 9.5 out of 10. So, thank you guys for watching and listening to my review, and hope to see you next week. Please subscribe, like, and comment. Bye.